So it's World Milk Day, which is June 1st. It's a day established by the Food and Agriculture Organization, FAO, of the United Nations to recognize the importance of milk as a global food. We have with us in the studio Senior Brand Manager, Peak Afolari Ojo, and the Vice Chairman, Nutrition Society of Nigeria, Lagos Chapter, Cecilia Peng. Welcome to the show, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Thanks for having
me. So good to have you. Now, you're on the show for Peak. Tell us about what Peak is doing this time.
Thank you. World Milk Day, it's a day set aside by the UN Food and Agriculture Organization, and it's celebrated every 1st of June. It's a day to call attention and raise the importance of milk, its consumption, especially for growth and development. For Peak, as the leader in dairy category in Nigeria and thought leader, it's a good opportunity for us to bring to life our campaign on why Nigerians should include Peak milk in their diet on a daily basis. And good to note, the theme for this year, for the World Milk Day, is to enjoy the power or the goodness of milk, which is translated as hashtag enjoy dairy. So our message to Nigerians, as we take them on a journey throughout this week, is to say enjoy the goodness of milk or dairy with a Peak breakfast.
Let me come to you, because the importance of milk, dairy products, obviously. Could you tell us why it's important, what the nutritional benefits of using, at least taking a glass of milk a day?
A glass of milk, I take it to mean a full glass of milk, right. Okay? Now, when you're taking milk, especially in the morning, with your food, depending on what kind of foods that you're having, you get a lot of nutrients. You have your vitamins, the minerals, and sometimes when it's fortified with vitamin D, you know that especially the children will not grow up with rickets. You know, they're going to have their immunity will be protected, their bones would be properly built. And apart from that, you also have the vitamin B complex, you have other vitamins, calcium, of course, that you know about. So you get quite a lot of vitamins, and of course you have the lactose, which is the milk sugar, the carbohydrate, and then you have for 244 grams of milk, maybe like a cup like this, you have about 8 grams of protein, okay, which is more than what you have in an egg.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so you, as long as you're taking as much as that.
Right.
Now, most people may not be, in other words, you might be taking like...
evaporated milk.
Yes. So you need to have to drink a lot, not just having maybe half a sachet or one sachet split over four people in a family.
Right.
You definitely are not going to get that.
Yeah. So what sort of activities have you created to celebrate, to mark your World Milk Day?
Wow. Oh, thank you. So starting from today with the Children's Day, we're celebrating with the children across four key cities, Lagos, Abuja, Enugu, and in Edo State. And our message is, we're giving the kids an experience of a Peak breakfast. So it's tying in with our campaign, which we launched this year, where we're telling Nigerians, let's improve on the culture of having a breakfast. But not just a breakfast, as we call it. It's a breakfast with Peak in it. And this week, we've called it, for us, a National Breakfast Week. Been the first ever of it to create the awareness for Nigerians on why you should take a breakfast that has Peak in it. Because research have shown breakfast is arguably the most neglected meal of the day. And it fuels you with the energy you need to do all you have to do. If you are able to make time for your breakfast, regardless of how busy you are, I had a cup just in the car. When I parked here, I had with a snack bar and then with a cup of tea with milk, with Peak in it. That helps you to power your day, you get more things done. Cognitive ability.
I've always wanted to ask this question, and it's a good thing you're here. My kids, when they want to take milk, and I notice that they always want to just take the full cream evaporated. Is that right, or should it dilute? Should it be diluted?
So
with cereal,
just like every consumption, it's based on preference. It is nothing is wrong with having the full cream milk as it is.
Undiluted.
Nothing is wrong with it.
Cereal,
like Cecile just mentioned, it's fortified. Mm-hmm. It's something you could have. So it's based on preference.
Right.
So what matters is make sure it's a peak milk you're drinking, because that's what you know is fortified with what you need.
So I wanted to ask, especially you, Cecilia, that, you know, first time I'm hearing about the difference in quantity and what that makes, you know. So how should people take this, to take their drink, to take the milk, to take the peak? How do you drink it in order to prevent the challenges of malnutrition? Because I know people say that by drinking milk, you prevent onset of the sicknesses that are attached to being malnourished.
You know, you're not just taking milk. You're usually taking milk with something else, except, of course, when you're drinking raw milk, you know, in a bottle, you can just pour it and drink it. But when you're taking milk and you're having a breakfast, for instance, my breakfast, what I'll do is dice my fruits. Mm-hmm. Whether pawpaw, mango, whatever is in season, or apples, whatever it is that is in season, I just add it into a plate and I roast my peanuts in there, and then I add maybe one or two spoons of garri instead of any of the cornflakes or any of those refined foods. Just add that, which is a more natural food, and I have my breakfast. That way, it's more nourishing. So I get the vitamins and the minerals, the vitamin C even from the fruits, and I also get the fiber from the foods.
So are you? Did your society verify the nutrients in peak milk?
Now, when you're talking about the society, you know, talking about verifying, verification of that is left to NAFDAC.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, let's talk about
it. So you have a campaign, WAMCO's visit to dairy farms in Oyo State. Could you please give us more details about that?
Okay, so our story with the dairy farmers dates back as far as back as 2011. And what we do with the dairy farmers is, this is where the raw milk, which we use in the production of our product, peak milk, comes from. And what we are doing is, across five different local governments in Oyo State, part of where I come from, we are going to the farmers to celebrate the great effort they do in producing the raw milk. And that's the story we call From the Grass, where the cows are raised, into the glass, like the cup you have on the table. So we're going back to the farmers to celebrate with them the World Milk Day and help them appreciate such a great job they're doing by nourishing Nigerians with this raw milk. And what better way to make the story complete by going back to give them an experience of the product that was produced from the raw milk, so that it can also have an experience of a peak breakfast.
So that's how exactly do we get doing. People, because I know that the breakfast agenda you put together is to get people to have breakfast.
Yes.
So what are the various suggestions you can provide? As what she just told us, that we can use peak milk in the mornings. What how do we use peak in the morning, aside from your tea?
Oh, beautiful one. So there is also a campaign with the brand we've been running for well over 3-4 years, where it says you can do a lot more with peak.
Okay.
Whether for those who do the cereal in the morning, or for tea in the morning, or those who do the pap, which is the local one. Every food you can think of, you can add peak milk into it, whether as a drink or into the food itself.
So soups.
So we wouldn't tell you to do into soups, but I've heard of soups, but I've heard of someone who did that to soups. So typically I know someone who has said it could be peak breakfast your way. So I imagine people who are on the street, when I have the bread and the akara in it, which is risky burger. And they just pour the powder.
Risky burger.
And they just pour the powder, they pour the peak powder into
inside
a glass. If you walk around the bus box, you'll see that. And then they just have it. So regardless of how you have your breakfast, there is a perfect way to add your peak milk into it.
So it's Children's Day. Is there any activities for the kids you're planning soon?
Yes, exactly. So we are today, like I said, we're at the Abuja National Stadium today. We are also in Lagos. We are in Enugu. And we're also in Benin City. Across these strategic cities, we are there with children this morning to sample them with a peak breakfast.
Oh, nice.
So across all these locations today, the children their breakfast is on us.
So in Lagos, where do we go to in Lagos?
We're at the National Stadium in Lagos,
where
we are sampling them. And the event is currently ongoing. I'm sure before 10 a.m. We should be fine.
So if you are actually it's still 9:30. So if you're in that area, you can actually stop.
Please walk into the stadium and have your breakfast. Right now, it's on us.
It's free.
It's on peak.
I wanted to.
It is free.
Sure.
It's on us today.
Thank you so much.
That's our way of showing that indeed, there is a lot more we can do when you show and walk the talk. And with that impact, we will take it on and say, Nigerians, this is it in your hands. Make sure you have a peak breakfast so you can have your day go well and be unstoppable.
Thank you very much, sir, for coming. Wednesday is our anniversary. We'd like you to send some peak for our audience. They will love it.
Well noted.